Erev Tov Chavrim, I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Very sad situation over in El Baghdadi, Iraq. Today, a U.S. Forces, a helicopter gunship, they were working on following some militants, ISIS militants in the area, when they mistakenly opened fire on a police and local official delegation of Al-Baghdadi, killing seven of their members there. It was definitely a tragedy for the Iraqi officials that were killed and police that were killed in this particular attack, and no doubt prayers should be offered as well for the U.S. servicemen there fighting in Iraq, because no U.S. serviceman would ever intentionally want to see the loss of life in an accident like this, especially when the Iraqis are allies of the U.S. This is a tragic day for both sides, as well as for those members that the accident occurred with. Also, another news as well. According to Sputnik, and there's other sources on this as well, that a number of civilians killed in the Turkish operations in Syria in the Afrin region, which is far the northwest side of Syria on the Turkish border there, has numbered up to 86 civilians thus far. Now, according to the Turkish government, they are saying that they have killed upwards to 400 Kurdish fighters, and the Kurds are getting reinforcements from other fighting groups inside of the country there, and still waiting to see whether or not Syrian President Bashar al-Assad will ever take a stand for the Kurds as well. I know that puts him in a very awkward position, with Russia being an ally for Turkey, a NATO member, mind you. And at the same time, Turkey is seeming to be at odds against the United States and President Trump's willingness to support the Kurdish fighters on the ground, and also declaring that he would make a 30,000 strong force inside of Syria. Now, that is a little bit awkward, because that would mean creating a Kurdistan, which is something that the Syrian government will never accept. And it also sets a precedent. If the President Trump is willing to stay and protect in Mumbai, where at this point now Turkey is telling the U.S. forces to get out or be attacked with the Kurdish fighters there. Now, understandingly, I realize Turkey is a NATO ally, but at the same time, President Trump has chosen to take a stand with the Kurds inside of Syria. If he moves the U.S. military from protecting or being with the Kurds in the eastern part of from Afrin there, that is really going to make him look very bad with the Kurds that have trusted the United States that they would be an ally to them in the region. Have to wait to see how that actually plays out. Also, one more thing here mentioned to you: in the elections in the Czech Republic, I thought it was so interesting. You know, we reported this recently. Milo Zeman, the former president and still president of the Czech Republic, was facing some serious criticism in news articles, making it look like that he would lose the election. Well, I guess that played out to his benefit. He did win the election, 51.36% of the vote. His competitor, 48 point some odd points there of the remaining part of the vote, with a 66.6% turnout. I believe that's what it was. Maybe I'm wrong on that number of the turn. Yeah, 66.6% turnout of actual voters voting there in the Czech Republic. Now, I say it's a good thing that Zeman got in. One, he's done a lot for the economy of the Czech Republic, working out deals with China and even with that of Russia, very much against the sanctions. And he is also very much an opponent of the mass movement of refugees from Western Europe into the Czech Republic. Whereas his opponent was very much in favor of those refugees coming in, anything to kind of make appeasement with the European Union. Anyway, congratulations, Milo Zeman, on your victory, and it'll certainly make the Czech Republic a little bit better as long as he's in office there. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Erev Tov.